I'd now like to introduce back to the podium, not at the podium or out in the auction, but Mr. Steve Dangle. Steve, to you. Here he comes.
Thank you, one lady over there who cheered. That was nice of you. So, for those of you who don't know me, I scream about the Toronto Maple Leafs on the internet, mostly on YouTube. I don't know where I got those traits. My parents, Tina and Gary, are here. I have an idea. Joe, there was that home run you hit, I think. My dad didn't see it because he was too nervous to watch. He was pacing around the basement, so I think that's where I get it from. And Sebastian, by the way, he'll talk your ear off after this forever. He's a drummer. 64 years old, just turned 64, in a metal band. He kicks the crap out of those drums. It's an amazing thing. So, anyway, the reason I'm here right now, it's the story of my sister, Rachel. And it's not unlike Hoora Lane's story. Rachel was born at 24 weeks. She went through many complications in the first few years of her life, especially the first year. Spent about 4 months in the NICU. I don't remember much of that as her older brother. I was a toddler. My parents were just making sure I didn't trip over stuff or unplug anything. I remember the gowns and stuff like that. That's what I remember. The better memories are the ones that we had at Easter Seals camp. And what I love about Easter Seals is they help kids be kids. That's the saying. Easter Seals helps kids be kids. It also helps families be families. And one thing that was a challenge for our family is getting out of the house, all four of us at the same time. And to prove how difficult it is, my sister actually isn't here tonight. She's at home, you know, singing. She'd much rather be doing that. Trust me, no offense to everybody. But I'm very happy that my parents, Tina and Gary, are here. Here's some photos, by the way, on the screen. There's, oh, look at the guns on that little guy. That's me at the front now as an adult. No. There's my mom. She's the one who looks exactly like me, but with long hair. Those camp experiences are things that I still remember today, and they were so much fun. They were fun for my parents, who still to this day tell me that they won coolest parents, was it? Literally just because you went to a concert the Friday before we left for the camp. What band was it? Just shout it out. Rolling Stones and Stone Temple Pilots. Sid Sixera was at that show. Was that at the X?
Show.
Woo! Yeah. There you go. So he was at that show. Rachel loved it. I loved it. We made friends. It was an accessible environment, which is harder to come by than you think. If anyone has ever tried to bring a wheelchair to the beach, you know what I'm talking about. So that was in my childhood. Years later, I think it was 2017, Ken Reed from Sportsnet, my coworker at Sportsnet, he said, hey, do you want to play in a hockey tournament? It's the Eric Lindros Celebrity Hockey Classic. You know, we raise money for Easter Seals. Now, I wanted to help Easter Seals, but the sad thing is, even though I screamed about hockey for a living, I had never actually played in a game. So, you're laughing now. I'm glad there's not footage. So, didn't go great. So I told Ken, I go, listen, I really want to help out, but I don't know how to play hockey. And he said, so? Which I thought was a compelling argument. So I ended up playing in the tournament, and we were really bad, and by that I mean I was really bad. My first shift, I fell down twice. I was a -2, and by the time I got off the ice, I tripped over the bench as well. So to me, that was -3 by the end of the shift. But had a really fun time. I think we raised about $4,000 as a team that year. The next year, Ken goes, I don't want to do all this work being the captain of the team. Why don't you do it? So me, being a really smart guy, I decided to captain two teams, even though I was like the worst player in the tournament. But collectively, we raised over $100,000 as those two teams. So, which, by the way, we are getting to tonight. We are getting over that and above and beyond. Those experiences I had as a kid, those awesome experiences I had as a kid at those camps, that's why I got on the ice and made a fool of myself. That's why I was tripping over my own stick. That's why I was tripping over my own feet. That's why I have been happy to be the worst player in a tournament for like 5 years. We did have the one digital tournament, and that was my best one. By far, my best on-ice contributions to the team. But talking numbers for a sec, just to break it down cold, hard facts, it's $250 a day to send kids to these camps. We need your help to generate these memories, to continue them forever, to let kids be kids and let families be families. You got to get off your wallet. You got to dump your purse onto the table. Let's help these kids. Let's help these families. What do you say?
Good job, man. Stay right there. Stay right there. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Dangle, one more time. I absolutely love this young man. Love him. Before we move on, Julia, can we turn on Eric Lindros' mic for just a moment?
Oh, boy.
Yep, we're going here. Because we got you?
Yep.
Just out of curiosity, when you saw him try and skate for the first time,
right?
Because you play.
I see money when I look at him.
I look
at a guy who does some incredible, amazing things when he goes to fundraise. Like, tell him about going to the theater and playing video games against people.
Oh, yeah. So
this is great.
So we went to, I think it was Scotiabank Theater. We rented it out, and we played video games. And basically, my friends and I, me, Adam Wilde, and Jesse Blake, as a podcast, were like, all right, challenge us to NHL 19. Or whatever it was. One guy in the first 10 minutes dropped $800 because he knew all the money was going towards Easter Seals. And I was actually pretty good because it was video games and not real life.
Well, you raised a lot of money through that. It was very it was unique and it was wonderful. It was terrific. No, he can skate. He can skate.
That's what I was going to ask you. Can he skate?
He keeps coming in, and it's wonderful to have.
The stones to do that in front of Eric Lindros. Are you kidding? I'm going to learn how to skate in front of 88. Wow.
I got a couple cheap assists on his line.
A lot of guys in the league's history got some cheap assists because of the work he did. A lot.